consideration of the EH antenna. In early 2000, a new type of antenna called EH antenna, which size was only 40 centimeters and enabled easy shortwave communication by simply placing it on the balcony, was invented abroad in early 2000. The most commonly used 7 MHz antenna in Japan is a half-wave dipole, which has a total length of about 20 meters and is considerably too long for persons who live in crowded cities. Building of long antennas becomes very difficult for many people. According to the practical knowledge, antennas that use shortening coils to shorten the antenna size. However, they have considerably poor radio wave radiation efficiency have been used on small areas. In such a situation, the efficiency of 90% or more, which is almost the same as the very long dipole with a total length of about 20 meters, is connected by cutting a large Coca-Cola aluminum can with an ultra-small antenna of only 40 centimeters and winding a coil. It is said that anyone can very easily make a high-performance antenna comparable to a dipole, so it seemed to many people as a phenomenal attraction that overturned the conventional knowledge. And great expectations were raised. According to the explanation of the monthly magazine article, one, cut an aluminum can of Coca-Cola and face it to form a capacitor of about 20 picofarads. 2. A parallel LC resonance circuit is constructed by winding a coil around a Coca-Cola can with copper wire. 3. Coil, a secondary coil to be coupled to 2, is constructed. And power is supplied by a coaxial cable with a characteristic impedance of 50 ohms. Was written. I myself was excited by the very attractive monthly radio article that a Coca-Cola size can obtain almost the same performance as a dipole antenna with a total length of about 20 meters. And all the monthly magazines of the special article of 3-month series I ordered to get all series of them. Already in the world. Radio enthusiasts around the world are excited as we are and have begun experimenting with this antenna. However, there was an experimental report saying the gain is not as expected. The power ratio is about minus 20 decibels and the transmitted radio waves are greatly attenuated. In Japan, 90% of ham radio station qualifications are fourth class ham radio technicians. So their maximum transmission power is limited to 10 watts. Ham radio abroad often said they are Japanese 10 watts. As jokes. Therefore, except for advanced license stations, the antenna power of most amateur stations is equivalent to 10 watts, which is equivalent to emitting radio waves attenuated to minus 20 decibels at a power ratio of 1 over 100. This means that only 1% of the total power transmitted will be radiated into space and the remaining 99% of energy will be lost. Where does the remaining 99% of RF energy go? If the transmission power is 100 watts, the effective radiation is 1 watt and the energy lost is 99 watts. With this, if a high voltage discharge occurs, there is a risk of ignition due to heat generation. Since PVC pipes are often used in the work examples in the article, they melt due to the heat generated by the metal parts and lose their shape. If this is a combustible material, there's a risk of fire. This is also a safety issue. However, on the other hand, there were also people who said, radio waves are flying well. In the commentary article one ordered, it was characterized by maximizing at 7 MHz, which is the frequency used by concentrated impedance. This is due to an article published in the 2009 monthly serialized magazine. The EH antenna constitutes a 7 MHz parallel resonance circuit as a 20 picofarad capacitor facing the Coca-Cola can. And a link coil with a small number of turns drives the resonance circuit of the Coca-Cola can. Coils and capacitors that are sufficiently smaller than the wavelength can be thought of as approximate to an electric circuit with a lumped constant and can form 1 over 2 pi root L. See Hertz tuned LC resonant in parallel or in series. It is appropriate to approximate this as a component of a lumped coil and capacitor rather than an antenna. In a parallel resonant coil, which is regarded as such a lumped constant, the impedance becomes maximum at a tuning frequency of 7 MHz. The antenna is not originally a component based on a lumped constant, but is treated as a circuit element called a distributed constant, and the inductance of the coil, the capacitance of the capacitor, and the high frequency resistance component have the characteristic of changing greatly depending on the frequency. On the other hand, the constants of parts due to lumped constants hardly change with frequency. This has a strong electrical dependency on the size of the component and the length of the high frequency wavelengths used. Unfortunately, the reality is that I rarely hear these illogical explanations nor write them in any books. As a result, the impedance of the parallel resonant circuit becomes maximum when viewed from the coaxial cable feeder side, which is the feeder line, so the EH antenna is considered to operate as a trap coil that cuts off the tuning frequency of 7 MHz. For this reason, most of the traveling wave becomes a reflected wave from the trap coil of the EH antenna and returns from the coaxial cable feeding part toward the transmitter. That is, if the coaxial cable is long enough, it behaves like a long wire, and the coaxial cable becomes an antenna. I thought about what happened in the EH antenna like that. Regarding the story of the person who said it worked well, the coaxial cable attached to the tower with a height of 20 meters operates as a long wire type antenna instead of radiating radio waves from the cancola body of the EH antenna. Then the radio waves are flying well. If so, rather, connecting a wire antenna with a 1/4 wavelength and a length of about 10 meters to the feeding point at the top edge of the coaxial cable should be much more efficient as an antenna. So I decided to stop making and experimenting with this antenna. On the other hand, this story is suspicious. Isn't it deceived? Is it true? Was also heard. One sect of opinion was discussing antenna performance from the electromagnetic theory of Maxwell's equations. In the discussion, the people seemed to be fiercely competing for a high degree of knowledge to show the correctness of their opinions. A group of young students who saw this discussion appeared insulting and laughing as Maxwell was very surprised. The elder who could not see such a fuss was furious. And some authorities tried to put in a furious argument by yelling, "You guys should stop fighting the empty theory without experimenting, just make an experiment." Under such circumstances, the theory said, "This is a similar case in the past. It is the same situation as with the isotron antenna. The isotron antenna is an example of a small antenna that existed a long time ago. And I think that few people in Japan knew about it. When investigated here, the isotron antenna was shaped like a rod antenna with a metal rod attached to the top of the LC resonant circuit, and had a structure slightly similar to the Zeppelin antenna, and was smaller." After that, the monthly radio magazine was crowded with articles about this EH antenna for a while. But I skipped everything and ignored it, and the content of the theoretical explanation was a false story that was not true, and all were discarded. Since the antenna should be analyzed and calculated as a distributed constant circuit, its electrical operation cannot be approximated by a simple lumped constant LC component model. It is reasonable to approximate an antenna that is sufficiently smaller than the wavelength as a component of the lumped constant, not as an antenna. It is expected that the radiation efficiency of radio waves will decrease as the size of the wavelength used is larger than the size of the cancola in the range that is slightly larger than the electronic component and smaller than the wavelength, such as this EH antenna. According to experienced people, experience and experimentation, I hear that the shortening rate of half-wave dipole antennas is about 50%, which greatly reduces efficiency. For example, in the case of a 7 MHz half-wave dipole, the shortening rate of 50% is 10 meters, so if the length is less than that, the performance will drop considerably. The EH Antenna operates as a trap circuit with LC lumped constant, and the coaxial cable connected to the feeding unit operates as the main body of the radio wave radiation unit of the antenna. So a strong electric field and magnetic field due to radio waves are generated around the coaxial cable. This makes it easier for interference to occur around the coaxial cable. With this, it is considered that it cannot be operated as an efficient antenna. With a parallel LC resonant coil, a very high voltage is generated by boosting. So care must be taken to discharge and generate heat. The EH antenna has a structure similar to that of a Tesla coil. And a high voltage is generated by boosting the electromagnetic induction of the coil. It is known in actual experiments that a parallel resonant coil is formed in the magnetic loop and is practical to some extent. However, a high voltage is applied to a variable capacitor, and sparks and air discharge occur even at about only 10 watts. This is a very bad characteristic of the magnetic loop antenna. It is also known that the 430 MHz magnetic loop melts the plastic suction cups due to the high temperature heat generated. In addition, regarding the strong electric and magnetic fields near the antenna, it is important to consider sufficient safety measures for the safety of human health. The adverse effects of strong, high frequency waves on the human body have been of particular concern for damage to nerve cells. As a power supply method, since the impedance is maximized due to voltage power supply, a wire that is an integral multiple of one wavelength can be connected to the end of the LC resonance coil, which should improve efficiency, but it is rather larger than a half-wave dipole. It will be more than doubled. Half-wave dipoles or single-wavelength loops are considered to have far better characteristics in terms of antenna performance and safety because the voltage at the feeding point is minimized by current feeding.